I'm a game programmer. That's what I do. I'm not an academic researcher on all that stuff, so I kind of feel a little bit out of place here, but hopefully what I have to share will be interesting.
Why do you feel out of place? The academics are supposed to be in the minority here.
Yeah, he is a perfect user, so for that reason, I'm
we're not being quiet enough, sorry.
If you have any questions, please. So in video games, the programmer speaks code, and we have a bunch of people, artists, designers, animators, sound designers, and others who create a team that plots upon the data. As it occurred to us over the years, that we often want to create our data like we create our code, almost programmatically, because it's so important, it determines so much of how the game works, and it can, errors in data crash the game and cause bad gear of all sorts. So we want to be able to check if we want to be able to. This way and that, we want to be able to source the data. So, some examples of the type of data. Some of the types of data that fall in this category are effect definitions, particles in your clients, animation states, and blend trees, which is the type of data that determines how a character walks and runs. Shoot the gun in terms of their animation. Events in games like scripting, basically the design of the game, and sound media, and many more things like that. So, in order to support this, we want powerful abstraction, we want flexible syntax, we want the language to be suited to each particular domain. So, actually, the namespace is the language is the recipe. At Naughty Dog, we have used Common Lisp in the past on the PlayStation 2 generation, and before we used Common Lisp to create our own implementation language called Go, and you can read that out if you need it actually. And when we moved to PlayStation 3, we chucked that whole thing out and got rid of it for a whole bunch of reasons. And in my opinion, we lost the baby with the bathwater. So I decided to try to recover a little bit of that because Lisp supports creating this data like code. It moves between the two worlds very well. So we put together a system called DC using MzScheme. We chose MzScheme because it's a good Lisp. It's open source, has all your libraries and implementation. So it was easy to experiment with it and get things going. And in fact, DC was not an authorized project. But now it's core to our way of developing games. So we used Scheme's syntax heavily to create a tower of evaluation to create our domain-specific languages. We built them on syntax on a superset of Scheme that is DC that can output binary data and simple self-header files. And syntax was the primary enabler of the projects and very creates language development. But it was also a source of inefficiency in computing for us. When I started this project, the number of people who knew anything about Scheme 1 at the company, and I didn't know enough. I learned quickly, but I was only one for a long time. And the syntax transformers. So powerful, so digital. It took a long time Here's what the architecture kind of looks like. We start with a VC file, a text file, and the compiler generates a C++ header and data files loaded at runtime in the game. And the actual C++ compiler grabs the corresponding C++ compiler, the header, and builds the executable. And so they go together. And the data file is loaded flexibly. Scheme code, which is lovely to write when you're writing games and you're always writing your tools in C++. This is like the biggest motivator for me for doing this. Now our tools, we can move runtime code into tools and we can use the power of Scheme to express what we want to do succinctly.
Not an ancient Google,
We actually used more on our previous paper, 9 gigabytes on the last game. We reduced it because we introduced dynamically loading just what we needed at every point, so we were able to use less. And we do crazy stuff like 16-bit floats and stuff along those lines in order to save space. And we garbage collect that heat by shipping things around.
So what's interesting?
And the rest of the memory you need it. Texture is a big thing. Materials. Let's see, sound takes a lot of space. We have deeper dynamic stuff. But yeah, geometry, texture, animation consume 60 megabytes in a level and another probably 30 megabytes. Ongoing continuous battle to fit. And everybody in the company, including engineers, designers, artists, is well aware of the impact they're having, or they're made aware of the impact they're having on every footprint. So that everyone can contribute. It's like performance and memory footprint are two things that no one person can solve by themselves. The entire company has to work together. In fact, it's a that it's worth. I believe when I know you have strengths is that we are able to work together to manage our memory and performance across all the different points. Frame rate is too low. Usually it's programmers have to make the game faster, but we instead create profiling tools that artists can see what they're doing to impact the frame rate. But yeah, I can go into a lot more detail.
macros expand, the errors are in terms of the expansion, or is it runtime errors?
In macro expansion. Thank you.
reactions of, you have a relatively small number of people building these ESL extensions, and a much larger number of people using them. What are the reactions? I guess you mentioned people using the user training C so that they go, oh, what are these round brackets? Or
yeah, there's a lot of that. There's a lot
or do
of
they go, oh, I can write 1/10 as much code, I get the same effect, this is good.
Yeah.
Or do they go, I can write 1/10 as much code, so I guess this is good, but I really miss my curly brackets.
Yeah, a lot of that. It's unfamiliar syntax. A lot of people haven't programmed at all, so it's very strange thing.
Does one type of program at all easier to adapt because they're not using?